Khalif Browder was 16 years old when he was accused of stealing a backpack by a man who changed his story several times. Khalif spent 3 years in jail, 80% of that time in solitary confinement. He received regular beatings by corrections officers. Eventually, he committed suicide. Khalif was never convicted of a crime. He always said he was innocent, even when pressured to take a plea deal to get out early. And after 3 years, the district attorney's office dismissed the charges when it became clear they had no case. So how did this happen? How did a 16-year-old boy convicted of no crime spend 3 years in jail? It all started because prosecutors demanded a teenager accused of petty theft pay $3,000 in bail, knowing it would pull him out of his young life, trap him in jail, even force him to plead guilty despite his claim of innocence. They demanded totally unnecessary and out-of-reach bail from young Khalif, jailing him. Khalif's story is not just tragic, it's an outrageous injustice. And there are far too many other stories of injustice like this around the nation. Hundreds of thousands are pulled out of school, pulled out of their jobs, pulled out of church, pulled out of their families and communities, trapped in an oppressive and racist criminal justice system by prosecutors, judges, bail bondsmen, and everyone else who profits from it. Mass incarceration, the United States imprisoning more people than any country on earth, it starts with money bail. District attorneys demand bail amounts they know are too high, which either keep people stuck in jail or force people to take unjust plea bargains and get stuck in prison, falsely driving up convictions so they can look tough, even though it has nothing to do with public safety or driving down crime. They use mass incarceration to build their careers. As mass incarceration expanded and the bail industry's influence has grown, the bail bonds industry has become a lot like the payday loan industry. It's built on predatory business practices, preying on black people and poor communities of color, whom the criminal justice system disproportionately targets. The money bail industry transfers huge amounts of money from everyday people to large corporations. Insurance corporations use bail to profit from taking away people's freedom. They trap people in debt, while bail bondsmen invade their lives, and they take people's money with no recourse to get it back. The bail industry also pays off politicians to block reform and keep the system rigged and racist for profit. In America, you're better off being guilty and rich than innocent and poor. Bail is the punishment you get whether or not you are guilty of the crime. While many white people charged with crimes largely spend the time before their trial free, district attorneys and judges have different rules for black people, for poor people, demanding bail in the first place, setting it far out of reach financially, threatening them with long sentences if they don't take a plea. It's either bail that is way too big for the crimes they're charged for, or charges that are way too big for the evidence against them. Either way, they trap people in jail, in debt, or with lifelong criminal records. It's your punishment for being black and poor, which has nothing to do with any real crime. Between 1990 and 2009, the percentage of people charged with felonies rose, and those who were required to pay money bail for their release increased by 65%. By design, the number of people jailed without even being convicted skyrocketed. These are people who deserve to be free, but have had their lives ruined by jail, even when their cases were dismissed or they won. Many spend more time in jail pre-trial than they would have spent in prison had they been convicted for the original charges. Police and prosecutors booked people in local and county jails 10.9 million times in 2015. How do we know it's a trap? Because 90% of the people in jail awaiting an end to felony cases are there, even though some amount of bail was set for them. But bail was set so they couldn't pay it, just like for Khalif. There is no legitimate public safety reason to allow these abuses to continue. There is no reason to lock people up simply because prosecutors are allowed to set bail too high. In fact, there is no real reason for money bail at all. The bail corporations and district attorneys in our criminal justice system have been winning and profiting, defending this injustice. But in the years ahead, we intend to change that story. We're going to win. Our communities are going to win. Our families are going to win. Justice is going to win. To be part of ending money bail and the racism in our criminal justice system, go to colorofchange.org/bail.